I mean, I'm still in awe. This is the first time using this Sony monitor and control app. And I've owned this camera for over a year. I have no idea how I missed out on it. It's brilliant. I mean, it's probably the single best app Sony ever released to us content creators and filmmakers. Wow, it's a field monitor in your hand with all the tools necessary for producing great content. You don't need anything else, in my honest opinion. Anyway, that's not today's topic. We're not talking about this app. We're talking about my LG monitor right behind me, because 2 weeks have passed and I've got to recalibrate my monitor. This is a hardware calibrated monitor and I have to use the LG Calibration Studio app on macOS. And of course, this app comes with a few quirks. So I've got a quick tip for you. So let's jump right in. This is the LG Calibration Studio app. This screen should look familiar to you if you own an LG monitor, which is hardware calibrated, because it's the only piece of software that lets you store the 3x3 matrix or in 3D LUT right inside the monitor. This is crucial if you use your monitor for reference. For example, if you use DaVinci Resolve with an I/O device, such as the Ultra Studio, which is a small card, and it bypasses the GPU to output an unbiased signal. But I figure this is an advanced technique that you don't need to necessarily get into. For our purposes, the LG Calibration Studio is just fine. The interface is simple. There are two options for calibration. The first one is obviously calibration, and the second one is 3D LUT. And those could stir confusion to you, at least they did for me, because I couldn't make out the difference between them. But I just stumbled on a report that clarifies this. So the calibration only stores a 3x3 matrix inside the monitor, whereas the 3D LUT option also validates the gamma curve, the transfer function, which you probably know as an S curve and will generate the proper contrast ratio. That's the main difference between those two. Prior to adjusting any option here, we head to the preferences. I know it still says Einstellung, and the YouTuber pointed it out that my system language is still German, and I apologize for this. In future videos, I will change my system language, so you don't have to bother with this. Anyway, for the sake of this tutorial and this being just a few tips, I will continue to do so. So right under preferences, there will be a profile category, which you find right in the middle. And this one is for adjusting the display profile generated during a calibration. And there are two versions that are universally accepted, ICC version 4 and ICC version 2. However, the crucial part is, depending on your day-to-day usage and which applications you run to for whatever purpose, like Photoshop or DaVinci Resolve, Lightroom, Capture One, you have to look up if this app is able to properly read and translate those ICC versions. If you aren't sure, I would stick with ICC version 2, because this gives you the least amount of problems, whereas version 4, sometimes macOS, ColorSync, and your whole color management pipeline could be a mess just by simply using the wrong version of an ICC profile. So keep this in mind. Beneath that, you find the validation options. And simply put, if you got more time, use the ISO norm, which will give you 141 patches, 21 of gray patches, and 120 patches of color. And if you pinch, just use basis, it will do just fine. I mean, we are not mastering any image for a big client right now, so that's totally fine. Now, with all those settings dialed in, you will see that the calibration tab and also the 3D LUT tab, there's not much of a difference between both of them, but the 3D LUT will give you a quick mode and a precision mode. So the quick mode takes roughly about 30 minutes, whereas the precision mode takes up to 1.5 hours. If you got the time, go for precision mode, otherwise use the quick mode. And if you don't care if the gamma function or curve will be stored inside the monitor, just stick with the normal calibration. That's absolutely fine. On top, you can choose one of the slots inside the monitor. So there are three storage slots for your target gamma and gamut. In our case, we could use the picture mode. This means one of the three slots, at least my monitor got three storage slots for different calibrations. Some of them are predefined, like the sRGB. This option will be called sRGB in the OCD menu inside the monitor. Also the P3 D65 mode. So let's contemplate that we do a calibration in the calibration slot. Then you can set the target color space that you want to use. For instance, if I would like to calibrate for the REC 709 with the gamma 2.2 curve, I could simply choose BT709. I set the target luminance to 100, which is the default. That's just fine. And the color temperature is D65. That's also perfect. The only setting that needs to be changed is the gamma, though, because 2.4 is the standard. But I would like to use 2.2 because I only deliver to YouTube. And then I would pick my colorimeter, which is not connected right now. You will just simply connect it to the USB slot on the monitor, and then it will show up. After that, you would click on the grade out proceed, and it will guide you throughout the calibration process. This is smooth. You don't have to worry about it. Once it's finished, though, and that's where LG Calibration Studio really messes up, is that normally, once the calibration has run through, you would think that you're set and done. But that's not the truth at all. Not if you're using the LG Calibration Studio, because the just created display profiles will not be stored in the systems folder, but in the applications folder of the LG Calibration Studio. What do I mean by this? Well, once you go in the system preferences, click on displays, and here we'll find a category called color profiles. There we'll find dozens of display profiles already pre-installed, such as display P3, image P3, Profoto RGB, but you will also find some custom created ones. For example, those from the BenQ Palette Master Element software. Normally, the display, once connected to your MacBook, will create an LG UltraFine. Just a general profile, it doesn't give you the most accurate colors, but it's usable, of course. And right below this, I've got my two custom profiles from the LG Calibration Studio. But the fun fact is, below, I got two of my custom display profiles generated by the LG Calibration Studio, which show up here. But they don't naturally after calibrating. So what do I have to do so that they are listed in the color profiles? It's a fairly simple step. Just go to the Finder. And if you don't know how to head to the LG Calibration Studio, just press Shift, Command, and G. This will lead you to the quick access for Go To. You can also just click on go to folder, and you have to use this tilde sign to go to library/LG Calibration Studio. There you click on profiles, display, and there we'll find some profiles which have been created after calibration. Sadly, LG thought that just naming them after the date, time, monitor would be a good idea, but it's not, because I have no idea to which slot they are registered, what gamma and gamut is set as a target. But I'm pretty sure you will figure this out. The important part is that you copy those files. So select them all, right-click copy, then you head to your Mac SSD or HD, go to the library folder, then go on to ColorSync profiles, and there's a subfolder called displays. There you just paste them into, which I did, and they will show up in this list right away. Good thing is they now have a different information that shows up. So by looking at the name, I can distinguish them now, because the 97 nits and D65 setting is my Rec 709 setting, while the 150 nits color profile is designated to my P3 slot inside the monitor, which I calibrated before. I really have to put emphasis on this, because you can do everything right beforehand. But if you don't select the appropriate picture mode inside the monitor and also select the corresponding display profile, your colors won't match. I guarantee you, it's a mismatch 100%. You must make sure that you always change the color profile to the one on your monitor. This also really highlights the BenQ palette master element software, because if you calibrate your BenQ with it, you also can designate hotkeys on your keyboard or use the Mac application to switch through the profiles and also the picture modes on the monitor via USB-C. So this is really handy. You cannot do this on LG monitors though, which is a bit disappointing. But considering the price tag and the quality you get, I really enjoy using the LG monitors. And I just make sure that every time I'm using or working in another color space, I will confirm by checking the picture mode on the monitor and also using the corresponding display profile. So there you have it. This is my quick tip on using the LG Calibration Studio software. If you got any questions, just drop them down below and I will get back to you. If you want me to have a rundown on different pieces of software, or want me to showcase the iDisplay profile software, or even the BenQ palette master elements, I will happily produce some content for you guys. So thanks for watching, and see you next time.